Hi Sagittarius and Sagittarius Rising, here's your horoscope for September 2024. I'm astrologer Joseph Anthony. All right, we're heading into that weird zone that I talked about at the beginning of 2024. We're in the fall season. We have this tremendous amount of energy that's coming in. And a lot of it has to do with the eclipses. Okay, this month we do have an eclipse. This is going to be right here in the fourth house. It's going to be in Pisces. It's going to activate all this energy in this fourth house. And I'll talk about that in a few minutes. So that's really the big news this month. But we also have Uranus going retrograde in your sixth house of health and service and daily routine. And we also have Pluto moving backwards into Capricorn for the last time in our lifetime. So as we start off the month, we have the sun at the top part of your chart here, normal this time of the year, going through Virgo, highlighting career, status, being in the public, responsibilities. All of this stuff is being highlighted as we begin the month. Now, this reading is for anyone who has a Sag sun or a rising sign in Sagittarius. This is a general sun sign reading in tropical Western astrology using whole house system. And this is a very basic general overview because I don't have everybody's birthday and everyone's birth chart and birth dates are different. So as we go along, your ruler is still moving forward. It was joined by Mars right there. And so last month should have been a very important time for many of you in terms of relationships and connections with others. And maybe you're feeling a little bit more feistier. But this month is going to be more emotional and sensitive because as we end the month, we'll have four planets in water signs. And, there's a lot of movement going on that reflects energy pertaining to the past or having to do with feelings about someone or something from the past or a situation from the past that resurfaces itself, especially when we have a lunar eclipse in the fourth house, which is one of the houses that represents the past. All right. So as we get started here, you're starting the month on a little bit of a social note because of Venus going through Libra. But the month also starts off with Uranus going retrograde in Taurus. So here it is in stationary position before it continues to move retrograde in this house. It'll do that for about 4.5 to 5 months. So things pertaining to health matters, responsibility, pets, your job, anything to do with health, whether it's diet, exercise, all of that stuff is going to be on the table. Now, if it's not you, it could be a family member, such as a pet or a mother figure, a father figure. You know, it could be somebody else in your life that's not doing too well physically. And so you may be helping them in some way. And I say that because of Neptune and Saturn in the fourth house, which has to do with caretaking because it's in Pisces. And this is about the mother. And this is about the home. This is about the foundation. This is about the structure. This is about the past. So my point being is that Uranus moving backwards through this sixth house is going to bring in subtly more responsibility in that area, caring for another or caring for yourself in some way. So you might be changing up your routine in some way possible as well. Now, also on the second, Pluto retrogrades back into Capricorn for the last time in our lifetime. It won't be back in Capricorn for another 240 years. So it'll be here and it'll continue retrograding back into the second house, which has a lot to do with money, finances, investments, wills, contracts, anything to do with the legal side and the financial side of life are definitely highlighted here, such as investments and stuff like that. And it's going to be here for a short time. It'll go retrograde until about the middle of October. Then once it goes and moves forward again, it'll move forward again and then return back to Aquarius in your third house on November the 19th. So this short period here could bring a lot of changes to your thinking and processing and your bank account and so on and so forth. So, but this is also has to do with values. So you're reevaluating everything in your life and your belief systems and your long-term goals. This is all under this umbrella in the next couple of months, especially with Pluto here and Uranus here. And so there's going to be a reevaluating of things in your life. Now, the new moon on the second highlights the career house as well. So it's going to be at 11 degrees of Virgo. So depending on where that is in your actual birth chart, that's the area you need to focus on. But a 10th house new moon is about being seen, being heard, getting more attention, maybe getting a raise at work, maybe elevating your stature in some way in the community. Maybe you're going into politics. You may be getting a job where you're working with the public. This is all under that umbrella. Now, it is Virgo. Virgo is the analyst. Virgo is the, the taking things and putting them together. And then I don't want to say being critical, but yes, it does fall under that umbrella, being very critical. Maybe you have a job or a business that requires a lot of focus. And this is going to be that theme here for the next 2 weeks. So this new moon is a new opportunity. If you're looking for a new job, or maybe you're going back to a job that you used to have, this could actually help you. Or a promotion of some kind, this could actually help you. So the new moon can be a very positive thing for the most part. Now, Mars enters Cancer on the 5th right there. Now, Mars in Cancer does not do too well because Mars is about a fiery get-up-and-go kind of energy, and Cancer is all emotional and moody and can be drawn into the past. And so it's in the 8th house of death and rebirth, transformation, shared resources, sexuality. And when Mars goes through this part of your chart, we do get nostalgic, okay? And as you can see here, we already have Saturn and Neptune in the 4th house of nostalgia and childhood memories. And now we have Mars in Cancer going through the 8th house as well. So once again, dealing with financial matters, because this is a financial house and so is the 2nd house. Dealing with financial matters, dealing with emotions and feelings regarding a family member or a friend, or maybe you're involved in some sort of contract with real estate or land or whatever it is, because Cancer rules land and property. And then you're dealing with the financial side of that. You know, maybe you're dealing with things pertaining to an inheritance, or setting up somebody's financial planning of some kind. It really depends on your own birth chart, but generally speaking, Mars going through this part makes us very moody, very sensitive, very psychic as well. Let's not discount that. And so you're going to be feeling all of this, and it's a very psychological house where you're thinking about every possibility and what's going on, and and so there's a little bit more concern when Mars is going through Cancer as well, because Cancers tend to worry a little more. Sagittarius is really not a big sign for worrying, but this could bring a little bit more worry about someone else, perhaps. Mercury enters Virgo on the 9th, right there in the 10th house of career. So now your focus returns to work and responsibilities and taking care of others and health matters. And again, this is going to highlight that for the next several weeks as well. But, with Mercury in Virgo, this is again talking about small details, focusing on the little details. Sagittarius is a sign that likes to do things on a larger scale, but Virgo likes to do things on a smaller scale. So you got to be, mindful of the little details when Mercury is going through Virgo. Now, we have the full moon lunar eclipse, which is the big news of the month. And here it is, lighting up that 4th house. It's going to be at 25 degrees of Pisces. So wherever that is in your actual birth chart, that's the area that gets lit up. But generally speaking here, the 4th house has a lot to do with home, feeling, and foundation. So many of you, in the course of the next 6 months, if you already haven't started, may be remodeling or moving or changing residence or buying land or buying property or selling property. This pertains to the mother, females. It's Saturn's also in this part of your chart, may have something to do with the father figure. But whatever it is, something is coming to a realization, an end, a completion, something to do with the home and a parent. This is also on the table. So over the course of the next 6 months, this doorway will be kept wide open in order for some change to take place. This is a very emotional alignment as well, the 4th house. So having to do with family members and the kids and caring for them in some way. So again, the theme seems to be health matters, finances, and something to do with the family or feelings or land or real estate are going to be the theme with this lunar eclipse. And so you will come to realize what it is either on this day or a week before, a week after. But that doorway will be open for some sort of recognition about this energy that's going to keep building. Now, the sun enters Libra on the 22nd right there. And now the energy shifts because the 11th house is about the future. It's about acquaintances. It's about organizations. It's about marketing. It's about technological stuff. And with the sun going through this part, and it's in Libra, the sign of relationships, you'll find yourself in a more social mindset or wanting to connect with others outside of your normal, comfort zone. And so this is going to help you in the next 30 days or so to get out and be around, to mingle a little bit more, and to find some organizations or groups that you find interesting, and more people watching. So this is going to be a time for acquaintances and new friendships, perhaps. And that is the theme here with the sun going through Libra. Now, Venus enters Scorpio, not the greatest time for relationships because Scorpio is your 12th house energy. And with Venus here, it's about the past. It's about reconnecting. It's about intensity. It's about psychic ability. Now, remember I said at the beginning, this is going to be a very sensitive month and there's a lot of emotion. And that's because Venus will be the fourth planet to enter a water sign. So we have Venus in Scorpio. We have Saturn and Neptune, Neptune in Pisces, and then we have Mars in Cancer. So we have four planets in water signs, which makes this a very nostalgic, very emotional, very sensitive month for many of you Sag rising folks, okay? So this is the theme at the end of the month. And last but not least, we have Mercury entering Libra on the 26th, asking you to get back to the basics and do the best you can and center yourself in the best way you can, finding inner peace, doing little things that make you happy, socializing, having important conversations. This is going to be the theme with Mercury going through Libra, along with the sun right there. So it's talking about the future, it's new organizations, and maybe some charities, and wanting to be a little bit more friendlier, okay? And you'll find that in some of your friendships or acquaintances as Mercury and the Sun make their way through the 11th house. All right, so there you have it. If you enjoyed this video and you want to learn more about astrology, stay tuned for a little presentation video I have at the end of this presentation. And have a great month, Sagittarius, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye for now. Hi, thank you so much for watching my monthly astrology. I really appreciate your support over the years. Have you ever considered learning astrology? Well, you're in luck because I've created a full online astrology course in my private community. It's a full 6-module course that takes you from the beginning of astrology, what it all means, the mythologies, the houses, all the way to the more advanced techniques such as progressions, solar returns, how to read transits, how to make predictions. It's all there in this course here. And I even dive into some of the mysterious stuff, you know, what some of the symbolism is all about. So I think you might want to check it out if you're interested. Along with the course, we have a very tight-knit community here where everyone helps each other out. And so if someone knows a lot about astrology, they help other people with astrology. So it's a community that really gets involved and, you know, really wants to learn and help each other out. But as you can see here, I have a whole lot more on this private community. I also have the Inner Circle live calls each week. Now, this is something that I do twice a month on YouTube, but here I do them on a weekly basis. And I talk about various topics. You get to ask me questions. We interact and we learn a whole lot more than just astrology. So this could be anything from astrology to what's going on in the world, predictions, politics, whatever it is. We talk about it in the Inner Circle calls. Of course, I do have videos here that I do not have on YouTube, so you get those too. And then I've got a private resource vault, which has videos that I suggest watching, books suggested reading, meditations, and more. So if you're interested in learning astrology or want to be part of a great community that's really growing fast, head on over to the link down below and click on the link and join today. All right, thank you so much, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Bye for now.